What up, everybody? It's your girl July from Kickback Couture, and today I'm gonna give y'all the sauce on a new chord plugin called Chordjam. There's all kinds of plugins for chords, but it's becoming harder and harder to learn how to use them. Chordjam is the complete opposite, in my opinion, and the company that made it, Audio Modern, does a great job at making their theory plugins easily usable as long as your DAW supports it. Reason? It doesn't work in Reason. But before I get into that, I have some more free sauce to give y'all. Isotope just joined forces with Native Instruments, and to celebrate the new alliance, they're giving away Native Instruments Hybrid Keys and Ozone 9 Elements for free, fool. You can also get a $25 coupon for both stores, but you must act now. This is only running through the end of the month. There's only a few days left. I'll drop the coupon code in the description and the link to the free downloads. Grab those as soon as you can, because like I said, you only got a few days left. All right, let's get into the video. Dope, so I got two new tracks in my Ableton session right now. Chordjam, and I got Contact. So in Contact, I'm gonna go ahead and select the Hybrid Keys 2.0, which you can get for free, as I mentioned. And I'm going to go ahead and select a preset that I want to use. I'm just going to go with this one for now, and we'll go back to it later. Chordjam, let's go ahead and set it up so that Contact receives the notes from Chordjam. Changing the MIDI froms and putting monitor on in. I'm select both of these. Now I'm going to open up Chordjam. Up here, I'm going to select my key. So I'm thinking something like F sharp will be cool today. Leave it on minor because we love minor beats. And let's see what comes up. Okay, yeah, those are some dope chords. So it'll tell you the chord type up here. So these are minor 7, add 11. I'm thinking I might want to hear something simpler, so I'm gonna put it on minor scale. Okay, dope. So rather than mess with this part up here and play my own chords, I kind of want to get something generated for me, especially since I'm like kind of in a rut. I kind of got beat block. So I'm gonna go down and turn the sequencer on. And I'm going to put this pattern on straight 4, so it'll play 4 chords for me. And let's hear it. Okay, so that's pretty dope. I actually want to change the chords. Maybe let's hear what else we could get. Okay, so I really like this 1, 3, 4, 5. Those are Roman numerals right there. If you didn't know, they're not just uppercase letters. So yeah, I'm gonna choose that progression, and actually I'm gonna keep Chordjam open, and I'm gonna change some of these to arps. So let me hear what it sounds like if I change this chord to an arp. I'm just gonna click arp, maybe up and down. Let's hear it. Okay. Cool. Maybe I could change the rhythm and do something like, maybe like this. I don't know. Let's see what happens. Okay. Okay, cool. I like this. So what I'm gonna do is drag and drop the sequence straight into Contact. on a contact channel. Whoops, there we go. And let's see what that looks like. Dope. And now I could go ahead and turn that off and put that back. Okay, I want to go ahead and duplicate this chord right here. Okay, yeah, that's really dope. So I'm going to duplicate this instance of contact. I'm going to delete the track that I have, and I'm going to change the preset. Not delete the track, delete the clip. And I'll change the preset to whatever's next. Let's see. Barrel house. Okay. All right, so I'm going to change this back to the chord. Take it out of art mode. Yeah, so that's dope. I'm gonna record that. So definitely I like going back and forth between the arps and the chords just to get different different variations. And you could choose down, up, up, down. There's different arp directions you could go with. All right, let's play this. Cool. I'm gonna duplicate contact one more time and get one with just chords and no arps this time. So this is the third one. And let's see which one of these presets sound good. We got Barrel House right now. I'm still playing Barrel House. All right, let's click on it and see. Maybe try this. Okay, cool. So yeah, now I'm gonna switch this to Chordjam and go into Chordjam, and let's make sure we're playing. Whoops. Chordjam. I'm gonna make sure we're playing all chords this time, so put everything on time. Dope. Let's find a better preset, one that is a little smoother. Cool, I like that. So I'm going to either you can record that in or you could drag and drop it. I think dragging and drop it is gonna be faster in this case. So drag sequence, paste, and I'm actually gonna go in here and drop the pitch down. I could have done that in Chordjam here, but oh well. Select all, and what I did was command shift and down. On a Mac, on a Windows, it'll be control shift and down. Dope. Now from here, I'ma just add some drums and do some mixing. Got the snare in there. All right, I'm finna hop on these hi-hats, and let me hide the info view. I'm gonna duplicate this a few times. These are just, straight two-step hi-hats, and the second, every other hi-hat is kind of shifted to the left a little bit, and the velocities are also, alternating up, down, up, down. I'm gonna grab my slice notes tool. If you haven't seen my video on the slice notes tool, check that out. If you're trying to slide hi-hats or something, then this could mess with that, but I doubt you'll probably be sliding your hi-hats. That's why that note keeps popping up. All right, I'm gonna do three right here. Don't show that again. Proceed. I'm gonna go to this first contact sound here, and I'm going to grab halftime. EQ out some of the highs there. Cool, so I'm gonna turn on the scale helpers here. I don't remember what F minor looks like, to be honest. So scale. Grab B for the pen tool, and let's turn on this headphone so I can hear what I'm doing. Gonna hit Command 3 so I can get triplets and make it a little bit smaller. Add some reverb to that open hat and the hi-hats. Got that Valhalla vintage verb on it. Cool, so I'm gonna speed up the tempo. It was at 120, let's try like 150, 145, 140, something. Yeah, I like that. Hey. Alright y'all, that is gonna wrap up this video. I hope y'all like Chordjam because I think it's really dope. The interface is real sleek and easy, just like Riffer. Riffer is one of my favorite melody making plugins of all time. Honestly, it's probably number one. It's the first thing I pull up if I need any kind of inspiration. I pull up Riffer, and now I have Chordjam to add to that. Definitely let me know what you would like to see next. It's all Couture, Kickback, and Cook Up.